overwhelming, you know, strategies to enhance and accelerate effective governance of the globe. We have the magic wand to give you so all the solutions. That's not the reality. I mean, we have paradigmatic limitations, and you see that paradigmatic limitations occur when epistemological assumptions are unequal to modern reliable real system behavior and practices in an larger panorama. And so, two examples, modern paradigmatic limitation example that we still use, one in engineering, in optimal control theory, system robustness. I mean, that kind of theory sent the man to the moon. So, but sometimes you forgot behind that theory, there was a large control room with over 150 engineers taking care of all the little details to be sure to hit the right target. So you see there are combinations. And then system risk analysis, the limitation of current system risk analysis. There are so many examples. The latest one is Fukushima. Okay? And still we use those tools. Because we didn't think just to announce them in the right way. And now, you know, you see my motto that we need new eyes. We need new eyes because observer says pour la plus grand part, imaginer c'est que l'on s'attend à voir. And then to observe for the major part is just to imagine what you already are waiting to see. And if you have the kind of attitude, we'll never find new solutions. You know, because you need creativity. It's not just observing what is here. You need creativity to anticipate scenarios. And so, according to that approach, we have a current system fragility because attempts to optimize a hierarchic system in the traditional top-down way only will be less and less effective and cannot be done in real time. The logic is to use distributed self-control, bottom-up self-regulation system, together the other one. I mean, not just one or the other, both of them. And complexity theory tells us that it is actually feasible to create a resilient social and economic order by means of self-organization, self-regulation, self-governance. Nevertheless, to achieve self-organization, self-regulation in a competitive, arbitrary, scalable system reference framework, we need application resilience and anti-fragility at system level first. We are just in a transition, in a turbulent transition, going from simple modeling, monoscale modeling, the reductionist approach, to a complex modeling, multi-scale approach. And we need new tools, more powerful tools. And that's the case. Le seule véritable voyance ne serait pas d'aller vers de nouveaux paysages, mais d'avoir d'autres trésors. Oh, the true research journey is not just to discover new territories, new countries, but to have new eyes. Again, I will never be tired to tell you this kind of thing. New eyes, we need new eyes. New eyes as new eyes to see, new eyes as individuals. Okay, new individuals, fresh forces. What is an arbitrary complex multi-case system? So simple, look at that. You know that? Does it remember you something? Anything? Yeah? Okay. So, enlarge our panorama. Systemic resilience modeling. We have to go from robust system modeling to resilient system modeling. Robust system modeling is the one linked to optimal control theory. Okay, the one I showed with great limitation. And so, from our cultural point of view, the reference for this kind of approach is given by Crawford Stanley only, as it introduced important ideas in the application of ecology and evolution, including resilience, adaptive management, and the adaptive cycle, and panarchy. I don't have time to go into detail of the panarchy approach, but this is the adaptive cycle, you know, the adaptive cycle metaphor. I think that anthropologists know quite well this cycle, but only them, you know. We need to learn. Many times you probably heard, oh yes, life is from alpha to omega. What is in between? in between. We find alpha, just growing, just accumulation of resources, and then conservation. And then when you accumulate too much and you are become too structured, too rigid, then if you want to interact with the environment, you have at least two options. You know, think about the two individuals that are just at this stage. They have two basic options: cooperate or compete. If you compete at this level, the outcome is war. If you cooperate at this level, the outcome is maybe. But then, for sure, if we don't do nothing at this level, we'll disappear. Omega will be disintegrated by the system, because the evolutionary system will prevail always on our reality. Okay, so it's better we understand that quite clearly. And so if we then from this point we can develop our resilience conceptual framework, and this is the system into focus, and we need two different levels that are able to interact with the focus that we are interested with, because otherwise our modeling will be always incomplete. Because they can just give us two more input information: the remembering from the top and the revolt from the bottom. Those are two fundamental components. And so the past approach was just built focusing only on system in focus. The new framework I am proposing, yes, it's a little more complicated, but the risk is that just to be less wrong than the past. Okay? And we need this level, but then coupled with two more. And then we'll be able to have a much modeling power to anticipate in a more reliable way what we're waiting for. And so the challenge for defining a CM system is, let's get over the limit. Okay? And so this is how. How is up to us. But it is fundamental to understand the difference between unperceivable and unmeasurable. Our science is based on measure, but unfortunately, our measurement instruments are limited by one parameter. You know, precision. So, all our decisions are based on limited precision instrumentation. All our science was developed on limited precision instrumentation, assuming that understanding was universal. What arrogance. Okay? It's an example, unperceivable. You like an example of unperceivable? Yes. Thermographics. You know, thermographic recording, something that we are not able to perceive, but instrumentation is able to record. Example of a measurement, okay? This is much easier. You love your children? How much? Can you measure that? And so, if you think about that, you'll be able to figure out the way to jump from quanta to qualia. But never forget, neuralizer work is always in progress, because you were educated from a past reductionist education. What we have been most successful strategy for applying to find the progress of the global level is just the first question that was suggested for this panel. The second one is this one, is what new or alternative strategy should be applied to achieve these objectives. What strategy can be adopted to more effectively address current threats, bottlenecks, impasses, and opposition? I think that all those starting questions have to be addressed with that kind of framework in mind. And now I open the discussion.